In the open, accessible life of the Restoration Palace, Charles made no attempt to hide his women. In fact, they were becoming celebrities. One of their biggest fans was history's most famous diarist, Samuel Pepys. His original diaries are locked away in his own library at Magdalen College, Cambridge. Written in shorthand, they're very hard to decipher. Wisely so, because they're full of Pepys's sexual misdemeanors, as well as lascivious references to Charles's mistresses. Barbara alone is mentioned 184 times.
And this one's particularly stalkerish behaviour. In the code version, he's left some words in clear, and those words are privy garden, castle mains, and bottoms. Make a sentence out of that.
Well, if you connect them up...
They do actually form a sentence, which is... OK, he's in the privy garden at Whitehall, and he says he sees the finest smocks and linen petticoats of my Lady Castlemaine's, laced with rich lace at the bottoms, that ever I saw. And it did him good to look upon them, the old perv. Don't you think? He's looking at her underwear, drying on the washing line.
You do have to remember that underwear was much more uncommon then than it is now.
These women, particularly Barbara, had quite an effect on him, didn't they?
Oh, tremendous effect. Yes, there is the occasion when Pepys goes to the Chapel Royal and he's registering that there's both the Queen and Lady Castlemaine, amazingly, in her nightclothes.
Mm-hmm. What happens?
Well, I did make myself to do the thing.
He did the thing? He did the thing with Lady Castlemaine and the Queen and all those people present.
By mere imagination, he experienced an emission.
He's in the room with the Queen and Barbara Castlemaine, and yes. he's got so excited that...
And to his own embarrassment.
To my embarrassment, too. And you are blushing. Oh, dearie me, Samuel Pepys.
With a new vogue for celebrity prints, Pepys could even collect pin-ups of his favourite crushes.
And this is Samuel Pepys's actual scrapbook. These are all of the famous faces that he decided to cut out and keep. This is the section where it gets really interesting. It's called Ladies, etc. He's got some historical figures. But flipping forwards, we get to the page of the royal mistresses. Here they all are. We've got Barbara, Duchess of Cleveland. Actually, she's looking here a bit like a man, almost like Charles II himself, I'd say. Here she is, looking over her shoulder in a different pose. Lovely pearls. Here is Louise, the Duchess of Portsmouth. Now, what's new about this is not the fact that the king had mistresses. This had been known before Henry VIII, etc. But now everybody knows what they looked like. And we've got the wrong idea about this. You think that horrible magazines like Heat and Closer were invented somehow in the late 20th century. Not so. This popular print culture goes right back to the 1660s.
For the first time, cheap printed pictures gave people at large a chance to leer at the rich and famous, and many grasped it enthusiastically.